Hello everyone, my name is Balram Sahu and I am plumbing faculty in Dhanush Engineering Services, India Private Limited. This session is for plumbing design. Let's know about what is plumbing design. Okay, before that we should know what is plumbing and why we need it. Okay, coming to the first question, what is plumbing design or plumbing exactly? So coming to the plumbing is nothing but it's a system or the network of pipe, fittings and other accessories which supplies water to plumbing fixture and drains wastewater from the plumbing fixture to the disposal point. Now the question is, you might be not knowing about plumbing fixture. So plumbing fixtures are nothing but all those appliances where we use water or consume water. Example, you can see wash basin, kitchen sink, taps, shower, etc. Okay, now coming towards the second point, why we need it. Because after construction of the building, that's nothing but it's all concrete work. We need to all have all the basic facilities. That is good quality of air, water and electricity. Okay, so let's discuss about plumbing design. And before that, we should know about plumbing cycle also. Okay, so before proceeding with the plumbing design, we should know about plumbing cycle. Now, what is plumbing cycle? I can assure you, you might have seen, but you never noticed about it. So let's see. It's about water from the reservoirs like lakes, rivers and the reservoir, like whatever the tanks will be there. From there, water will be supplied to the main tanks in our building. That is overhead tank and underground tank. Then water will be distributed to like plumbing fixtures where water will be used and it will be drained out. Okay, with the help of pipes to the disposal point, and from the disposal point water will be treated and it will be again sent to the reservoirs, and this cycle will continue, which is called as plumbing cycle. Coming towards the plumbing design, this entire course is divided into four specific modules. First, water supply. Second, drainage system. Third, rainwater. And fourth is firefighting. So let's talk about each in design system. Now, before proceeding with plumbing design, we should know how to design and for designing purpose, what are the data required. First of all, we should know about the type of building, and the second parameter is NBC standard. Now, what is NBC standard? Nothing but it is a like specific standard book in which you will get all the parameters, design parameters related to plumbing. Now, coming towards the first module, that is water supply system. In water supply system, what we do is we need to supply water. For that, first parameter which we should know is that is water calculation. Now, how to do calculation? With the help of types of building and with the NBC standard. As already in the last topic, we have completed water calculation. So now, for supply purpose, we have to store. You can see like overhead tank, underground tank. So we need to calculate the tank capacities. For supply purpose to every plumbing fixture, every user, what we have to do? We have to do piping. That is called as from overhead tank to internal, all the internal plumbing fixtures, called as internal pipe sizing. Why we need to do pipe sizing? To maintain the discharge and pressure. So as we saw that water will be supplied from overhead tank to all the plumbing fixtures. But how we will get water in our overhead tank? That is quite obviously from underground tank to overhead tank. For that also we need pipes. And secondly, we have to pump water. For pumping purpose, first of all, we need pump, and to select a pump, we require two important calculations. That is pump head, that is nothing but to calculate pressure required to pump water from underground tank to overhead tank. Secondary, pump capacity, in which you will get all these parameters required. Now coming towards supply system, that is distribution system, there are four important systems are available. That is direct supply system, gravity system, direct pumping system and hydropneumatic system. But nowadays we are using only two type of system, that is gravity as well as hydropneumatic. By this we have calculated pump, tank, water requirement and everything. Now we supplied water, that is from underground tank to overhead tank, from overhead tank to all the plumbing fixtures. That is we have done. Now as per the requirement, the pressure has to be maintained and the discharge, whatever is required, that has to be supplied. For that we will estimate. We will estimate the pressure at every floor. In gravity system, mostly on the top floors we will get low pressure. Now what do you mean by low pressure? What will be the pressure?
So as per the NBC standards, 1 bar is the minimum pressure in our water supply system, and the maximum limit is nothing but 3 bar. So if the pressure in building is less than 1 bar, we have to use booster pump, and if the pressure is more than 3 bar in the lower floors, we have to use pressure reduction station to reduce the pressure. Similarly, we have to proceed with the hydropneumatic system also. There also same pressure estimation, pump calculation, pipe size calculation, this will be there. Okay, now in this entire system we are going to use pipe. Without pipe, water cannot be supplied, right? So for that we should know the different types of pipe, because based upon the water supply application we have to select the different material of pipe. Like we have UPVC, CPVC, HDPE, TPR, GI, that is galvanized iron, and CI, that is cast iron. These are the most used pipes. Now this is how we have completed with water supply system. We know about water supply system. Now from there we have to discharge, because after supply water we will use, and after usage wastewater will be generated which has to be drained out to the disposal point. So here we comes with the next module, that is sewage system. Coming to the sewage system, first of all what we have to do, we have to drain the entire wastewater from all plumbing fixture to the disposal point. For that, first thing is we should know about the types of plumbing fixture and the number of plumbing fixture we should install in our building. Now we have to calculate the number of plumbing fixture. Why? Because in a, suppose we have an office building, there so many people will be there. So to fulfill the requirement of all those people, we need to do the required calculations which will estimate the number of plumbing fixture which will be occupied by the people. Okay, now in order to remove all the wastewater we have to run the pipes. Now coming to the pipe running process, we have two different pipes, that is internal and external. In internal we have again three pipe running process, that is sunken slab, false ceiling with minimum sunk, and that is raised flow. Now coming to the external, we have one pipe system, two pipe system, and single stack system. Now all the sewage will flow from plumbing fixture to internal pipes and to the external pipe, and from there it will go to the manholes. Now coming towards manhole, first of all we should know about the types of manhole available and which manhole will be suitable for our building. Now in this we will teach you how to select the pipes, also how to calculate the manhole depth and slopes also. Manhole depth will be depend upon the discharge, how much discharge is there, and slope calculation. First of all we should know about slope calculation. Why we need to do slope calculation is nothing but, here if you see, if you don't maintain the proper slope, you will find like all the sewage will stuck in the pipe only. It will create a jamming issue. So for that we should provide a positive slope so that entire sewage will go, it will flow proper way, so that all the jam issues will be rejected. Now coming towards rainwater system. Why we have to deal with the rainwater system? Because it's related to water. Now first question is, why we should deal with the rainwater? Because as per the records and survey, India is a home of around 16% of the entire world's population and has only access for 4% of consumable water. It will also get deplete easily if we not consume it properly, and due to also overpopulation. So for that what we can do is nothing but rainwater harvesting. Now in rainwater harvesting we have two ways. Either we can collect all the rainwater in our tanks and we can use for different applications, that is for gardening purpose, for car washing, for HVAC cooling tower, etc, etc. Other ways, we can increase the underground water level so that it will help us in the future in the dry seasons. But for that we need to have a recharge bit. Now let's see about recharge bit. So you can see in the screen, this is nothing but a different layers by which rainwater will get filtered and then it will transfer to the underground water level, which will enhance the water level in the underground, which can be used with the help of wells, ponds and bore wells.
Now the same thing we will understand with the help of an example. You can see in the picture, like rainwater will be collected from the terrace with the help of rainwater downtake pipe. So now water will be discharged into the rainwater tank. This water will be utilized for the various applications. Example, like for the gardening purpose, car washing, HVAC cooling tower, etc., etc. Now the remaining overflow water will be supplied to the recharge pit. The function of recharge pit, as already we discussed, nothing but to increase the underground water table.
Okay, so this is nothing but with an example we have seen. Now moving towards firefighting.
In firefighting, first of all we should know what is fire and why we have to deal with the fire as a
plumbing engineer.
First of all, what is fire? Fire is
combination of three elements,
that is oxygen, heat and fuel. Okay, now based upon the type of fuel, we have six classes of fire. Okay, and for every class of fire, different type of extinguishers are available. You can see in the screen, based upon the class of fire, suitable extinguishers are available. Now in firefighting, what we have to do is, first of all, firefighting. For firefighting purpose, we have two specific system, that is hydrant system and sprinkler system. Coming to the hydrant system, what is hydrant system? It is nothing but red color pipes inside the building which you see generally. Those are all hydrant pipes in which water is always available for the fire extinguishing purpose. With the help of landing valve, hose reel pipes, first aid landing valve, first aid hose reel drum and nozzle. The entire setup is placed in a box called as firebox. If the same setup is placed inside the building, it is called as internal hydrant, and this setup is placed outside the building called as external hydrant. Now here we have to see what is its coverage area, what should be the pressure and everything. Here all the calculation will be based upon NFPA standard, that is National Fire Protection Association. Not only hydrant system, we also do have sprinkler system for the firefighting purpose. Sprinklers are, you can see on the screen how it works. Sprinklers are like automatic, they detect the heat, based upon that it will blast and it will discharge water for fire extinguishing purpose. We have to know about the different types of sprinkler, that is pendant type of sprinkler, upright sprinkler and sidewall sprinkler, and where it should be used, that is its application, what will be its coverage area and how many sprinklers are required in our building, everything. In order to supply water to all the firefighting system, that is hydrant system and sprinkler system, we have to supply water with the help of pipes and pumps. Again, we have to calculate it. Now moving towards next topic, that is nothing but detection system, because without detection we cannot go for the fire extinguishing purpose, we cannot do firefighting. So in detection we have basically two different types. One is manual detection and another is automatic detection. Manual detection, you might have seen red color small box as you can see in the screen, that is called as manual call point. And with that we have hooters, we have control module and we have fire alarm control panel which will run the manual detection system. And in automatic detection system, you can see we are using electronic sensors to detect the fire. Detectors, we have different modules, that is heat detector, smoke detector, beam detector and multi detector. And with that, to control the detectors and to monitor them, we have various equipments, various electronic circuits called as control module, monitor module, fault isolation module and response indicators also. This is what the automatic detection system includes. This is about the detection and firefighting. Now coming towards the very important factor, that is nothing but safety standards. So here we are also going to learn about fire safety standards, about refuge area, fire tower, fire lift, fire brigadier inlet, etc., etc. So overall in Dhanush we are going to learn about plumbing and firefighting both in such a way that we'll make you ready for the industry. And thank you for watching the video.